Hi everyone, my name's David.
And I'm Ro.
And we have been traveling in our RV for almost 4 years now. And over that time, we have gotten a lot of help from various apps that we have on our phone. So in this video, we want to share those apps with you guys so that, you know, it will make traveling in an RV as easy as possible for you.
So in this video, we're going to be talking about the 9 essential apps for travel and RVing.
The first app we're gonna talk about is Gas Buddy. And we use this app all the time when we're traveling across the country from one destination to another so that we can find the cheapest fuel available on our route. And the great thing about Gas Buddy is that it's not just for gasoline, it is for various fuel types. You know, we have a diesel truck, so we need to find diesel fuel, and Gas Buddy allows us to filter the results to only show us diesel fuel prices. And there are different ways that you can see the results as well. You know, it can list out the fueling stations in order of cheapest price as a list, but it can also show you the nearest fueling stations to you in a map view, so you can be sure that a station is along your route. And once you find one that you want to go to, you simply click on that fueling station, select directions, and it will automatically find you directions and show those to you in Google Maps. And so you can navigate very easily using Google Maps. One thing to keep in mind though is that all these fuel prices are submitted by app users. And so if someone reported a price a day ago, it might not be accurate. However, if someone reported a price, you know, within the last few hours, odds are it's gonna be pretty accurate. And it tells you how long ago the price that you see on the app was reported, so you can know whether or not it's gonna be accurate. Also, Gas Buddy has some perks. If you consistently report prices on the app, you can rack up points that I believe you can use to receive money back on gas or enter you in to win prizes. We're not exactly sure on the specifics of that because we don't take advantage of it, but if you're interested in using Gas Buddy, you can look into that for yourself.
The next app we want to inform you about is an app called RV Dump Sites. And this app is kind of special to me because we have always had a difficult time finding dump sites. And when we very first hit the road, it seemed like such a daunting task every time we would try and find one, especially when we were trying to find ones that were cheap. And luckily, I finally came across rvdumpsites.net, which is their website version of their app, and it was a lifesaver. All of the dump stations in an area are listed on this map, and now there isn't always a ton of information on all of these dump sites, but it gives you a really good idea of what might be offered at any specific station. It tells you the pricing. It tells you whether or not there's potable water, fresh water, and rinse water available for you when you're dumping. Now, on the RV Dump Sites app, very similarly to the Gas Buddy app, all of those locations and the reviews and the information provided has all been input by users of that website, so you're gonna wanna take some of the information with a grain of salt. And David and I are pretty good about whenever we go to any of these dump stations, whether they're permanently closed, and it wasn't reported on that specific location, or it is awesome and we loved it, we leave a review so that if anybody is using the app, they can look and open any of those locations, and at least we know we've provided accurate information. Now, like I said, using this app has been a massive headache saver for us in whenever we're going to a new location. We can either find a dump station nearby for us to dump at before we actually leave for our trip, and also a dump station on our way to the location in order to fill up on our fresh water, and it has been just so fantastic.
The next app we want to talk about is a free campsite and campground finding app, and it's called The Dirt. And while it is free, it does have a very inexpensive paid version that unlocks a lot of functionality. The Dirt is the best campsite finding website and smartphone app we've ever used. However you camp, in a tent, Trailer, RV, or cabin, the Dirt makes finding accommodations easy, and with over a million listings, you're sure to find the perfect campsite. The Dirt website and app are free to use. However, they have an extremely affordable Pro membership available for only $3 per month. Pro has many indispensable features for travelers like us, such as offline access and downloadable maps so you can search for campsites anywhere, map overlays for BLM land, national forests, and national parks, so there's no questioning what land you're on, and a trip planner so you can see all the campgrounds and fuel stops along your route. A Pro membership will also get you up to 40% off at hundreds of campgrounds across the country and up to 30% off camping gear by many major brands. Now we've spoken to the Dirt and we've actually been able to get you guys a 10% off promo code. So if you go through the link in the video description below and use promo code FATE, you can save 10% off on an already extremely affordable campsite finding app.
One of my favorite apps on this list is my white noise generator. And I love this app because not only is it insanely easy to use, but it is so nice for those nights where there is just too much noise outside to be able to get a really good night of sleep. Now, we use the white noise generator app that we have mostly for when we are traveling between destinations and we have to stop somewhere that's busy or going to be noisy, like a Cracker Barrel that's near a highway, or if we have to overnight in a Walmart or something along those lines. It makes it so that we're able to sleep through at least the majority of the noise that's going on outside. But I have also used it for some heavy thunderstorms that make it a little too difficult to sleep at night. Now, I love this app so much because I am able to customize so many different sounds and save that specific type of sound configuration off in order to use it again in the future. And it has things on it like just fan noise, it has white noise, it has brown noise, it has like a babbling brook, it has people talking in a cafe, just all sorts of things that you can use to configure your perfect sound in order to sleep the best on any given night.
The next app that we recommend is called SkyMap. And that's because, you know, when you're traveling and camping, there's no doubt that eventually you're gonna find yourself outside on a clear night. You know, maybe sitting around a campfire with your friends and everyone's looking up at the night sky. And you might be wondering, you know, what is that constellation? What's that star? Is that a planet? And using SkyMap, it will tell you exactly what the celestial body you're looking at is. It also shows the location of nebulas, and also if there's a meteor shower going on that night, it will show the best place to look at in the sky to see that meteor shower. And what's so cool about it is that if you take your phone and you just point it at the star in question or that part of the night sky, it will show you that right there on your phone. And as you move your phone around, it just uses, you know, the technology in the phone to know exactly what direction the phone is facing, and it will just show you exactly what is in the sky on your phone in that direction as you move it around. You can even look down to the other side of the earth and it will show you that as well. It's just a really great app that has excellent functionality and usability for figuring out what everything is out in the night sky.
One of my most favorite apps that we use is arguably probably one of the most obvious on this list, but it is AllTrails. And I love AllTrails so much because I can download those maps. Not only is it excellent for finding trails in the area or specific trails in a national forest or a national park or out on BLM land, but you can also save those maps so that if you are out on that trail and you don't have signal, you can still pull it up and see your location so that if for some reason you might get a little lost, which has happened, we have gotten a little lost sometimes, we can easily find our way back just by looking at that map. Now, the reason I love AllTrails so much is because it has so much searchability. Not only can I search for an exact difficulty of a trail that I'm looking for, but I can also make it so that it is only a very specific length. I can also check to see if pets are allowed on the trail so that we can take Sweetie or Alice with us on the trail. It has been an amazing app for being able to go out and find those awesome hikes we love to show you guys so much.
The next is actually two apps, but they're basically the same thing, so we're lumping them together, and that is Uber and Lyft. And the reason that we are including these is that, you know, sometimes you just don't want to take your vehicle to, you know, whatever attraction or restaurant or whatever. You know, you'd want to leave it behind at the campsite. And it's really nice to have those ride sharing apps to take you there and bring you back to the campground. And the reason we say that you need both is because sometimes, for whatever reason, one of them is going to be a lot cheaper than the other. And, you know, you may take Uber to the attraction and then find that the ride back is cheaper with Lyft. And we've done that plenty of times. It's really good to have both. One time that we used these rideshare apps a lot was when we were visiting Las Vegas. You know, finding parking for our truck was just, oh, just nearly impossible. And so we were actually camped in the parking lot of Circus Circus, and we just called Uber or Lyft to take us all around Las Vegas wherever we needed to go.
And finally, probably the most obvious app that should be on this list is Google Maps. Now, while it does seem like it should be the most obvious, we have gotten a ton of questions over the years on what GPS type app we use, whether it is like what a trucker might use in their truck to find low bridges and make sure that the routing is all correct and, you know, trucks are allowed to go down that road, or something that is very specific to RVs and RV travel. We don't use those because our rig is short enough. It's not super long or anything like that. So we purely stick with Google Maps. And I don't think that I really need to go into all of the functionality of Google Maps because I'm sure most of you probably already use it to some extent. However, something that we didn't know we could do until we hit the road, and something that we know for a fact a lot of people don't actually know about, is the ability to use GPS coordinates to find a location and also use Google Maps to figure out what your current GPS location is. And it's pretty simple. All you do is you zoom in on your location, you press and hold on the screen, and it'll tell you what your GPS coordinates are. So you can copy those and paste them into like a text message and send them off to somebody that might want to know where you are. You can also take GPS coordinates that someone has sent to you, copy them or write them down, and then just type them out into Google Maps, hit enter, and it'll show you that exact location. It's really convenient for trying to find campsites. It's really convenient for trying to find where we parked our rig. I know that's a major question we have always gotten, is how do you find where you parked your rig at last? And that is, we just know what our GPS coordinates are and we write them down or save them. And then if we've gone out into town and we think we might have a hard time getting back, we just pop them into Google Maps and it takes us right where we need to go. It is really amazing and we love Google Maps. Those have been the 9 must-have essential apps that we personally use in our day-to-day travel. And we are aware that there are some other apps out there that some of you may also use, and if you really like them and you think that, you know, other people would really like them too, please mention them down below. We know that there are a ton of other apps out there, so it would be awesome if other people could know about those as well.
Now, we have Android phones, and that's what all of these apps have been. We're not sure if they're all available for Apple as well, but if they're not, then I'm sure you'll be able to find a good replacement, a good substitute that is available for Apple products. But we hope this video was helpful for you guys, and we'll catch you later. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, is that
you? Bye. Yeah.